stop and question. Young Circle. Connections to house 1, 4, 6. US 1 and Pembroke Road. Connections to routes 1, 5, and 101. US 1 Breeze.
Thank you. Ya te vas a tetero.
Tell you every what, like the third as soon as the second, but call that one. All right.
Okay. Thank you so much.
All right. Let me get this card. See. Look out, mommy. You want to sit there? I don't think it's gonna go out this way, but I'll try. Let me back up. Beep. See if it's too wide or too narrow. Let's see. Yeah. There we go. Just gotta do it straight. All right, yay, we went through, come on. I will never have. Practicing. Hey.
This is security advisory. For your safety, please do not leave baggage unattended. Unattended baggage will be removed and may be discarded. All persons must maintain control of their personal property, including carry-on baggage and checked baggage, to avoid transporting items without your knowledge. Carrying firearms through a TSA screening checkpoint of an airport is
111 so that law enforcement officials can thoroughly investigate. We thank you for your attention to this important issue.
Yeah.
April 29th, and I am heading back to Tampa, guys. I was gonna say, like, yeah, I wanted to be Miss Little Trooper and ride it out, but that wasn't really my intentions in doing this. My intentions in doing this, like, move was more so to, like, get out of my environment, explore, see what else the world has to offer. Obviously, I wanted this to be a little bit more permanent, but I, like, had to just, like, kind of, like, talk to myself and tell myself that it's okay if it's not permanent. Like, nothing has to be permanent, you know what I mean? Like, as I'm, like, struggling, like, oh, if I leave, then I just gave up. It's like, okay, when you decorate your room, do you just decorate your room one time and leave it like that permanently? No, you keep moving your room around until it makes you feel comfortable. And so that's kind of what, in a sense, this me leaving and going to Miami was. It was more so for me to go and see, one, if I could stay, two, if I like it, if I fit, and, you know, just, like, yeah, just see what it would be like. And obviously a lot of changes have occurred. Like, I was supposed to be in West Palm, I ended up in Miami, and then from Miami, now I'm in Aventura, then I ended up in Fort Lauderdale. I kind of just been all over the place with this trip, but it's been like a cool 3-4 days. A lot of learning and stuff. I don't know, I'm kind of glad I had this experience because it's really made me realize how important it is to have, like, friends and, like, a companion, a man, your husband. Because, like, this is fun and stuff, and money too. Maybe I can't really say because I don't have money, but I feel like this trip wasn't as fun because I didn't have money or, like, someone or other people to enjoy it with besides, like, my kids, you know what I mean? Like, obviously, I can't, like, talk about, like, my struggles and, like, oh, what should we do? Like, just like that, like, with the kids, you know what I mean? So right now, I'm heading back to Tampa. Basically, right now, I'm in Fort Lauderdale Airport. I was in Aventura. I had to take the bus from Aventura to Fort Lauderdale. And now I have to take the tri-rail. Well, now I'm here at the shuttle. Apparently, you're for the shuttle to the tri-rail. I'm assuming it's somewhere here in the airport. Then this tri-rail will take me to West Palm Beach. And then from West Palm Beach, I will take the Greyhound back to Tampa. The Greyhound comes to West Palm Beach around 9-ish. And I should get to Tampa by 3:50 p.m. Which is great because today I have my multi-family event. Everything worked out. Oh my God, guys. Let me not even get into the shelters. So I'll try to just briefly explain what happened at the shelter. So yesterday I went to go meet with the shelter that I, like, had went to go meet on Saturday, and they told me to come yesterday Monday. And, like, basically these people had, like, no good news for me, guys. They were just, like, doing an intake on me, and, like, I'm explaining to them, like, guys, I literally have nowhere to stay. Like, I've been sleeping in the airport. And they're like, alright, well, we'll put you on our wait list, you know, it's been weeks since we've been able to place a family. So, like, weeks go by and they place one family. I'm like, oh, this is not gonna happen today or tomorrow. And then, yeah, and then I just kind of, like, overall felt like no one was taking me serious, like, which I understand, unless you're homeless or you've been homeless, or you're with the person that's homeless, you're not gonna know what it's like to be homeless. So it's easy to shrug it off, like, oh, well, sorry, you know. But they don't know, like, the agony of being homeless and not finding a place to sleep, being cold. The lights are on depending where you're sleeping. Like, you can't, like, get a good night's rest. I was able to kind of rest, but it was, like, half-assed because I was, like, worried about the kids. But yeah, overall, the shelter that I went to go meet, it was just like not it. But they did have a lot of services. They offered showers, they offered bus passes. They give you like, you need like a birth certificate. They gave you food. We had lunch there. We didn't really eat that much, but that was the idea. We ate there. They gave me a couple diapers and wipes. A couple, as in like six diapers. Which is fine. It held me off until later when I went to Publix. So yeah, I got a lot of snacks for this road trip. So yeah, guys. So basically, they said they're going to put me on the wait list. And so I'm just going to wait for them to contact me. And depending on what my life is like at the time they reach out to me, I may come back, may not. But I can't keep doing this to the kids, like having them sit in strollers and like all uncomfortable and stuff. Like, I knew that that's what I was gonna have to do, but I thought I was gonna like work something out by now. And like, I don't know, I just, honestly, I'm hesitant about the shelter, because like, even just being in that building, it's like a lot of people seeking shelter, like, they kind of like look poor, they act poor. Like, I don't know, let me not be a judge a book by its cover, but I didn't get any like entrepreneur vibes. Maybe a little bit from some moms, but a lot of the people were like homeless, you know what I mean? Like literally homeless, like they're not like homeless and like trying to like go back to school or start a business. Like they're just homeless and lost and weak. And so a shelter is cool, but the idea, if it means that I have to be around people that are ambitious and stuff like that, then I kind of am just better off being miserable at my grandparents. Because yeah, I'm not trying to put my kids like around like people that have like no motivation to succeed and stuff and like don't keep up with themselves, you know. Like I cannot put kids through this. Like, this is not a good representation of me or my kids, like being around these people, being in this facility right now. So I just left and had to call my grandparents, and they sent me money for the ticket, and here we are. So I'm gonna stay around and wait a bit and see what they say. That airport is freezing. I feel like they make it extra cold, so it doesn't make homeless people want to stay there as much, because I sure as hell do not want to stay in there. It feels so good out here, but I don't feel any mosquitoes now, but I guess there would be some. It feels really nice outside. I do not have any plans of going out. But yeah, I'm going to try to connect to Wi-Fi, see what's going on with these shuttles. The kids are free, right?
Correct.
Okay, so yeah, just
7:50, and you need to hurry up because you need to get to the other side.
Okay, yes, ma'am.
The end of the sidewalk on the right hand side and the right across the track. Maybe your train should be here in about 7 minutes. Fine, right there.
Thank you. To West Palm Beach. It is currently like 8-ish in the morning. And yeah, we're just waiting for our Greyhound. It is pouring. Like, when we got off the train, it was just like those strong waterfalls that fall. And so there was no way around it. We had to like plot like these. Like this, like how it's heavier than most of the rain. I guess because it gathers right here. So me and the kids had to like cross through this little like area right here. And so we didn't get too soaked, but we are wet. And so it's not too bad, but it sucks in this case because we have no spare clothes. Like I don't have any clean clothes for them. So we're just going to have to air dry it out, which is not the best thing to do because obviously I don't want the kids to get sick. So yeah, so we're just going to wait here. I have to use the restroom. I still have not changed Max's diaper. She didn't let me earlier this morning, and then like I just didn't expect like the train ride to be as long as it was. And yeah, so she's done her same diaper since last night. And so I'm going to change the diaper as soon as I get a chance, but I don't want to keep getting her wet, so I'm going to wait for the rain to stop, and then we'll go ahead and change the diaper before we get to the greenhouse. So yeah, Jess is fussy, you're going to try to feed him too. I'm not taking Jess a bath in like 2 days. Oh my god, yeah, we need to get home, guys, and get our lives together. This trip has been very crazy for us.
I'm going to go to the hospital. moving here.
Hey guys, so from Publix for our snacks for the trip, we got some dirty deli style potato chips. These are the jalapeno heat. I love these. These are kind of like the Miss Vicky's, but like, I don't know. I like these better actually, better than Miss Vicky's. I don't know if it's the bag. We got some Driscoll's blackberries. I could call them blue raspberries. I don't know. Got my favorite salads. I don't know if it's still good, but honestly, not gonna lie guys, I'm still gonna eat it. These are bistro Santa Fe style with chicken salads with salsa ranch dressing. I love these. They make eating salads super easy. And then this is just like a leftover sandwich. It's just a sub on wheat bread. I could show you. It's a sub on wheat bread with mayonnaise. My side had Gouda cheese or Chipotle Gouda, but this one's just American cheese, yellow American, with boar's head turkey and mayonnaise, yeah. So we're still gonna eat that. I mean, we got it like late last night, guys, and it's still pretty early, so we're not gonna die, I don't think. And then more blackberries. Okay, and we also got got some Publix old-fashioned lemonade. It's a little bit too sweet, but when you're hungry, it's like kind of refreshing in a weird way. We got some the Good Crisp Outback Barbecue potato chips. These were okay. Then we got Max some Hawaiian bread. Get it fun? Maybe she said yeah. All right, we're gonna give Max some Hawaiian bread, King's Hawaiian bread. And then these are my favorite Z-bars from Cliff Kids. I was gonna give these to my nurses when I gave birth, but I left them at home. But these were gonna be the treats I brought for my nurses and like the midwives and all that. So yeah, oh, and these are the oatmeal. I haven't tried the other ones, just oatmeal. And then we got some mandarins. These are cuties mandarins. cousins. Muchas cousins.
They're just blowing smoke.
They're still wildly competitive. Highly competitive. Very young.
One thing I highly recommend is a senior only, and you have others.